Today we are going to see about exercise number 4, 12 occur come 18, which is the sequence diagram drawn for the system. A sequence diagram is an interaction diagram. It shows how objects operate with one another and in what order. Usually the sequence diagram will be having parallel vertical lines called lifelines. The lifelines are used to tell how long the task is stayed in an object to be get completed, and the horizontal arrows indicates the messages exchanged between them and in the order in which they occur. We can use this for several scenarios, and the sequence diagrams are also called as event diagrams or event scenarios. This is your locker cum ATM. We have drawn the sequence diagram here. We have split up the cases sequence diagram into two cases. The actors used in the model is user 1, user 2, and an authenticated user, and the object used in the design model is bank robber and bank server. We have used the valid login and invalid login cases for the sequence diagram. Valid login. In this case, the user 1 is this is for a joint account. User 1, user 2 are in the same account. User 1 is going to access the bank locker cum ATM with his login password, and the ATM will send it for the validation process to the bank server. The bank server, once if it is get found to be valid user, it will give the message to the user 2 that user 1 is accessing the locker. Only when the permission is granted by the user 2, the bank server will grant the access to the user 1, and the user 1 can open or close the locker and can do his or her operations in the locker. If it is invalid login in the sense it is given to the bank server. Once it is found to be invalid user, it will also send a message called prohibit the access. And the access is prohibited, and an alert message is also sent to the user 1. Thus, our sequence diagram is analyzed successfully.